Hey, good morning, holy people. Welcome to St. John Paul II on the fourth Sunday of Ordinary Time. It's good to be back. Hawaii was absolutely beautiful. Had a great trip. Every time I drove past a Catholic church, I thought, I wonder if they need a pastor. But very pleased to be back home. I want to welcome any visitors with us today. Anybody visiting or here for the first time? Do we have anybody over here in this section visiting our first timers? What about over here? Any visitors or first timers over here? Oh, we're running out of sections. Any visitors or first timers over here? We don't have any visitors with us today, so that's a little bit unusual. Norma Lamb, our parishioner, died this week. Her funeral liturgy will be celebrated on Tuesday at 11 a.m. up at the St. Joe Hill Chapel. The visitation will be from 3 to 8 p.m. at Newcomer Funeral Home on Monday. Our St. Gianna Pro-Life Group meeting was moved from after the 8:30 Mass today to after the 11:15 Mass. So if you'd like to join them, they'll be meeting in the old school building and everyone is invited. Our parish mission is scheduled for Sunday, February 12th and Monday, February 13th. Mike Patan will be our mission speaker, and his topic will be the questions of Jesus. Over 300 times in Scripture, Jesus asked questions of his followers, such as, what are you looking for? Who am I? Who do people say that I am? Do you believe this? Mike will help us see how those questions that were asked 2,000 years ago are still applicable for us today. So we invite you to consider coming on Sunday, February 12th and Monday, February 13th. Now, some of you may already realize that Sunday, February 12th is also Super Bowl Sunday. And you might ask, how in the world did they schedule a parish mission on the same day as a Super Bowl? Because we don't pay attention. So we apologize for that. But we have moved it to the afternoon on Super Bowl Sunday. So at 1:30 on Super Bowl, 1 o'clock on Super Bowl Sunday will be the first part of the parish mission from 1 to 2:30. And we'll have some food, light snacks before that. And then the second one will be Monday evening, 6 to 7:30 with Mike Patan. So this is a free to the parish. We will take up a free will offering, but there is no charge. In addition, Mike will have some selected merchandise available for those interested. Having just returned with 38 of my closest friends from Hawaii, I'm now gearing up for the Holy Land pilgrimage in May of 2024. So not this May, the following May. I don't have all the details yet, but I do have the dates, so you can mark it on your calendar if you're interested. May 15th through the 24th of 2024. This will put us in the Holy Land for the Feast of Pentecost, which is kind of exciting. So we're trying to rearrange the schedule a little bit so that from the typical thing, so that we can have Mass on Pentecost Sunday near the upper room where the first Pentecost occurred. So save those dates if you're interested. If you'd like more information or just want to be on the mailing list for information about that, just send me an email and let me know that, and I'll put you on there so that once we get things finalized, we'll be sending those emails out to you once we get that more information on that. This weekend kicks off our Catholic Schools Week. It gives me an opportunity to thank Karen Haas and all of our teachers and staff in our parish school for all that they do throughout the year for our young church. The school is hosting an open house immediately following this Mass until 2 o'clock. Even if you don't have kids or grandkids or anyone in the school, but you just want to see one of the major ministries of our parish and what they're doing, we invite you to do so this afternoon right after this Mass. We will have prayer ministry after Mass. If you have any prayer needs, come up and see our prayer minister and they will pray with you. We are a growing parish, as I've said many times, and one of the ways we try to keep small is by having a prayer partner at each Mass, and we get a prayer partner by introducing ourselves to one other person and then praying for that person throughout this liturgy. So I invite you to find a prayer partner at this time. Thank you. Thank you for doing that. We don't get much quiet in our lives, so I'm just going to invite you to take a moment now as we prepare to celebrate this liturgy, and just kind of quiet yourself so that we might celebrate it well.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the Catholic community of St. John Paul II as we join in singing our opening song this morning, Come, Now is the Time to Worship.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Thank you. And once again, I welcome all of you to the celebration of the Eucharist on the fourth Sunday of Ordinary Time. That we might celebrate it well, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners to repentance. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You intercede for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you
I invite our young people forward for our children's liturgy of the word. This is open to children kindergarten through fifth grade. And everybody come and stand on this side of the book. Everybody on this side of the book. Everybody on this between the book and me. There we go. We'll get you up there. And let us pray. Grant us, Lord our God, that we may honor you with all our mind and love everyone in truth of heart. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Come, O children, come and hear the word of God. Come, O children, come and learn the word of God. Come, O children, come and love the word of God. Glorify him, and love the word of God.
A reading from the book of Zephaniah. Seek the Lord, all you humble of the earth, who have observed his law. Seek justice, seek humility. Perhaps you may be sheltered from the day of the Lord's anger. But I will leave as a remnant in your midst a people humble and lowly who shall take refuge in the name of the Lord, the remnant of Israel. They shall do no wrong and speak no lies, nor shall there be found in their mouths a deceitful tongue. They shall pasture and couch their flocks with none to disturb them. The word of the Lord. And thanks be to God.
Merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned. Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned. Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned. Be merciful. Have mercy on me, God, in your kindness, in your compassion, blot out my offense. Oh, wash me more and more from my guilt and my sorrow, and cleanse me from all of my sin. Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned. Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned. My offenses, truly I know them, and my sins are always before me. Against you alone I have sinned, O Lord. What is evil in your sight I have done? Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned. Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned. Create in me a clean heart, O God. Put your steadfast spirit in my soul. Cast me not away from your presence, O Lord, and take not your spirit from me. Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned. Be merciful, O Lord, for we have sinned.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Consider your own calling, brothers and sisters. Not many of you were wise by human standards. Not many were powerful. Not many were of noble birth. Rather, God chose the foolish of the world to shame the wise. And God chose the weak of the world to shame the strong. And God chose the lowly and despised of the world, those who count for nothing, to reduce to nothing those who are something, so that no human being might boast before God. It is due to him that you are in Christ Jesus, who became for us wisdom from God, as well as righteousness, sanctification, and redemption, so that, as it is written, whoever boasts should boast in the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he had sat down, his disciples came to him. He began to teach them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are they who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be satisfied. Blessed are the merciful, for they will be shown mercy. Blessed are the clean of heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are they who are persecuted for the sake of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
I invite you to take a moment and say a prayer for your prayer partner at this time. Thank you for doing that. Today I'm kicking off a three-week homily series called Join the Journey to Pray. This is the first of three homily series that are part of our annual stewardship campaigns. For those who are new to our parish, every year our stewardship committee invites us to reflect on how we use our gifts of time, talent, and treasure to grow as a disciple of Jesus. Because our faith journey should never be stagnant. It should never remain the same. We should always be about growing our faith. Each year, a theme is chosen by the stewardship committee that connects all three of the series for that year. The theme for this year is Join the Journey. And so today, I'll speak to you about joining the journey to pray as we talk about stewardship of your time. Sometime late summer, I'll speak to you about joining the journey to serve as we examine the stewardship of our talents. And then in the fall, I will invite you to join the journey to give as we look at the stewardship of our treasure and how we give back to God through the use of our finances. But today I want to start by inviting each of you to join the journey to pray. Today's first reading from the prophet Zephaniah begins with three simple words: seek the Lord. Seek the Lord. The prophet Zephaniah spoke to the Israelites about 600 BC. About 600 years before Christ. And we know that because the first book of the book of Zephaniah begins with these words. The word of the Lord, which came to Zephaniah, the son of Cushi, the son of Gedaliah, the son of Amariah, the son of Hezekiah, in the days of Josiah, the son of Amon, and the king of Judah. So we know it took place during the reign of Judah, which was sometime right before the fall of Jerusalem in 587. So Zephaniah spoke during the reign of King Josiah, which was about 640 to 609 BC. And I tell you all that because I have this fear that one day you're going to make it to heaven. Now, that's not my fear that you make it to heaven. That's not my fear. My fear is that when you make it to heaven, you're going to run into Zephaniah, and he's going to introduce himself to you. He's going to say, "Hi, I'm Zephaniah." And he's going to get this blank stare. And he's going to say, "You know, Zephaniah, you know, the prophet Zephaniah, as in a reading from the book of the prophet Zephaniah. I wrote one of the books of the Bible," and all he's going to get is his blank stare. I just want you to be aware of him so that when you do get to heaven, no one in this church can say, "Zephaniah, Father Tom never talked about you." And so this weekend, I'm going to invite you to take a few moments today to read the book of the prophet Zephaniah. It's a short book. Only three chapters, a total of 51 verses, and a message that's very simple: come together to avoid God's judgment. In chapter 2, verse 1, Zephaniah proclaims, come together, O shameless nation, before you are driven away, before there comes upon you the anger of the Lord, before there comes upon you the Lord's wrath. And then he says, and this was the start of our first reading today, seek the Lord, all you humble of the earth. You who have observed his law, seek justice, seek humility. Perhaps you may be sheltered on the day of the Lord's anger. Join the journey to pray is about us coming together as a parish to recommit ourselves to grow in our faith as disciples of Jesus Christ. One of the interesting things about Zephaniah is that it wasn't just doing bad things that he was warning against. It was also a warning against complacency, people just going about their lives and forgetting about God and their relationship with God. And that is where I'm afraid many of us find ourselves today. We get so caught up in our lives and all the tasks we have to do with our daily living that many times we forget why we are living. We forget about our God. Some of you in this church today are old enough to remember the Baltimore Catechism. How many of you remember the Baltimore Catechism? Got a few hands up there. Remember that. All right. Baltimore Catechism was a kind of question and answer catechism. And the first question in the Baltimore Catechism was, who made us? Do you remember that? And what's the answer to that? Who made us? God made us. Yes, exactly. And what about this one? Why did God make you? Now, don't answer that one, because there are different forms of the Baltimore Catechism. The original Baltimore Catechism said this: God made us to show forth his goodness and to share with us his everlasting happiness in heaven. some catechisms after the Baltimore Catechism combined that into this one. What must we do to gain happiness in heaven? And the answer to that was, to gain happiness in heaven, we must know, love, and serve God in this world to be happy with him in the next. Know, love, and serve God. To know God, to seek the Lord, is what our stewardship of our time is all about. Finding ways to grow in our faith, finding ways to grow in our relationship with God. In the coming week, you'll receive via email 90 ways to grow your faith. Next weekend, we'll have hard copies of that same document available to all of you. During this time, this week and next, we invite you to join the journey to pray. We'll be asking each of you to choose one or two options from that list or come up with options of your own, ways to grow your faith this coming year. But we're asking all of you to write down and make a written commitment on the bottom of that paper, a written commitment that you're going to do in choosing to grow your faith for this coming year. We're going to ask you to put it in an envelope and address it to yourself. 2 weeks from today, we'll ask you to bring those back as part of our commitment individually and collectively as a parish to work on and to do something to grow our relationship with God in the coming year. So you'll receive the email this week. We'll have hard copies available next week. And then on February 11th and 12th, we'll invite you to bring those back in that self-addressed envelope. Nobody will read that but you and God. We're going to have those sitting up here somewhere in church for the next several weeks, so you can bring it back if you forget it that week. Bring it back the next week and just put it in with those. Put it in a self-addressed envelope, because we'll mail it back to you. We'll mail it back to you at the end of Lent so that you can say, okay, how am I doing in this commitment that I've made to my God? Why do we do this? We do this so that we can know, love, and serve God in this world and be happy with him in the next. Almost right, you can be seated again. I forgot something, sorry about that. False alarm. I invite our candidates and catechumens forward for our rite of dismissal. I invite all of you to extend your hand in prayer toward these people who will be coming into our church at Easter. Loving God, we thank you for the gift of these candidates and catechumens as they go forward to reflect more deeply on the Word of God, which has been proclaimed here today. We look forward to the day when we will share fully with them at the Lord's table, but for now we send them forth in your peace, and we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now I invite all of you to stand as we together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and life for the world to come. Amen. And with confidence now we place our prayers of petition before our God.
For the church, that we may be poor in spirit, unassuming, humble, and giving, making God the center of our lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our world leaders, that they will strengthen their efforts to be peacemakers among all nations, races, and cultures. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who suffer for the sake of their faith, especially those who live in places hostile to Christians, and those imprisoned or silenced because of the gospel, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish family, that the parish mission on February 12th and the 13th will not only be a celebration of faith, but will lead each parishioner to develop his or her own relationship with Jesus, our Savior, while pondering questions Jesus asked of his followers. We also ask blessings on our presenter, Mike Paulton. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, that they may rest in the arms of our loving God, we especially remember Norma Lamb, our parishioner, Skeet Combs, the brother of Joan McKinley, Wally Smith, the father of our parishioner, Jill Brock, and Kenny Price, the father of Beverly Hagest. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Hogan Sissel, who is the intention of this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own prayer request, those of our prayer partners at this Mass, and for the prayers written in our parish prayer books. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, hear the prayers we present to you this day. Grant what you find good in them through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
As we prepare our altar for the celebration of the Eucharist, please feel free to come forward with your personal offerings or items for our local food pantry. Our offertory song is "We Are the Light of the World."
Blessed are they who are poor in spirit, theirs is the kingdom of God. Bless us, O Lord, make us poor in spirit. Bless us, O Lord, our God. Lord, our God, we are the light of the world. May our light us, O Lord, when we share the sorrow. Bless us, O Lord, our God. O Lord, hear our cry for justice. Bless us, O Lord, our God. We are the light of the world. May our light shine before all, that they may see the good that we do and give glory to God.
Pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to Almighty God. May the Lord accept the sacrifice
at our hands
for the praise and glory
of God's name,
for our good and the good of all God's holy church. Amen. O Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Almighty and Eternal God, through your beloved Son, Jesus the Christ. He is the Word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit, and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with all the angels and all the saints, we too declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim.
Holy, holy, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In the same way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread,
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. We humbly pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, with Charles, our Bishop, with all the bishops, all the clergy, and all your holy people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. And have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, with St. John Paul II, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we too may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. Through him and with him and in him, Almighty God, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen, 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 amen. As Jesus taught us, we dare to pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins then, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Thank you. And let's share with one another now a sign of Christ's peace. And behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. And may the body and blood of Christ preserve us all unto everlasting life. Amen. Amen.
God will provide for all that we need.
God of my present, my past, and future too. Although your Spirit is upon me, for my search for shelter from your
I invite all of you to join me in praying our mission prayer. My dearest Jesus, may we journey through life with you, with our hearts beating in unison, our souls in harmony, our thoughts one with yours, as we accept your invitation to a deep personal relationship. May we achieve these lofty goals through our parish mission. As presenter Mike Patan, help us to answer the questions that you, Jesus, pose to your followers in the gospel. What are you looking for? What do you want me to do for you? Do you believe? We ask that you richly bless our presenter and participants as we explore our own answers to your questions, Lord. This we ask in your holy name. Amen. And let us pray. Nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, O Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And I do thank you for your participation in this liturgy as I ask God's blessing upon you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and be with you forever and ever.
Amen.
Go forth now in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.
And as we go forth, let us join in singing, Your Grace is Enough. Your face.